everybody, Paul Turner here from thediscipleproject.net with video number 9 in my series called Real Youth Pastors Don't Starve, based on the book by Jeff Goins called Real Artists Don't Starve, and it is my attempt to convince you, the local youth worker, that you are in fact an artist. You're painting a picture of God to your students using your gifts, abilities, and talents that God has given you, and you're using things like sermons and small groups and illustrations and activities and camps and all those things, all to paint a picture of who God is and let students know that God loves them and cares about them. And so I want to encourage you that you are in fact an artist. If you've chosen not to believe that yet, I hope this is the video that convinces you. And like many youth workers, we are always trying to figure out how to get the respect we deserve. And there's so many youth pastors and children's pastors and others, because they don't have the high and lofty spot maybe of lead pastor or senior pastor or any of those things, they tend to not garner the respect of people around them because their job is seemingly lower in position. But there's nothing further from the truth. In fact, children's ministry, youth ministry, they are the lifeblood of the church. So how in fact do we get the respect that we so desire? And don't kid yourself, we all want it. We all want to be respected for what we do. It's no different than any other profession. So how do we get there? The key to getting the respect that you're looking for is that you've got to value the work that you do. And part of that is seeing yourself as an artist and not just a drone and not just a person that shows up and shuffles papers and cleans the floor and the toilets and all these things. That the work that we do is on par with a carpenter who builds a house and a chef who cooks a meal. And we would never disrespect them. We'd say, that's a great house or that's a great meal. And so we have to take the same kind of pride in it that those other professions do. Here's a quote from Jeff Goins in his book, Real Artists Don't Starve. He says this, the rule of value. The starving artist works for free. The thriving artist always works for something. And as artists, we must value our work before others will. So how can we do this? How can we value the work we do and therefore garner the respect from other people? Let me give you 3 ways we can do that. Number 1, we can say no to the right things. See, listen, being a servant is not the same as being a slave. We are slaves already to Christ. We're not slaves to man or to the church or to a pastor. Our lives and our families are worth more than the ministry we serve. We must value the word no. We have to say no. We can't say yes to everything. We have to say no for the sake of our families, and sometimes we even have to say no for the sake of our own souls. Because we value what we do, we stay in our lane, right? We don't overextend ourselves, thereby keeping our souls and our hearts pure and emotionally free from a lot of garbage and resentment that could get in there if we're not careful. The second thing we can do to get the respect we're looking for is don't be afraid to ask. If we value the work that we do, we can ask for things. Now listen, if you're a volunteer that happens to be also the primary youth leader, listen to me. You don't have to be afraid to ask and say, I'm going to turn in this receipt for this meal that I bought with a kid, or I'm going to turn in this receipt for gas. And you know, sometimes we just poor mouth ourselves and say, oh, it's okay, it's all right. The problem with that is that if we do that enough, eventually we start to feel a little bit of resentment in our hearts. So what we should do then as a volunteer or even as bivocational, when we put value on the work we do, it's okay to turn in a receipt. The third way that you can garner respect is by not making excuses. Now listen, I'm not saying you are making excuses. I'm saying that all youth pastors, just like anybody else, can make excuses for why they can't do something or why they can't do something well. Listen, we should always give our best. We should always take pride in what we do. And if we want to garner the respect of others, then we don't make excuses. We say, listen, the budget doesn't determine my effort. It's determined by my will. I decide to put my best effort into everything I do, whether that's messages, retreats, small groups, whatever it is, whatever my level of ability to do it, I'm going to give my best to do it. The excuses we make for not doing our best decreases the value and therefore the respect that we receive in doing it. Your time is worth something. Why not make your time count? Make it valuable by doing your best. The ministry, listen, the ministry you do is worth something. Don't let other people exploit your gifts and talents. Serve unselfishly, but serve wisely. Jeff Goins says this in his book. He says, if you're feeling resentment at all, you're charging too little. We have to be able to put a price tag, if you will, on what we do. And that's not necessarily a financial price tag. That's just a gut check price tag that we value it, that we think what we do is important, even though other people do not think that. Feeling underappreciated can lead to resentment. But if we value what we do, then resentment's going to stay at bay because we find our own satisfaction in knowing that we are doing our best with what we have. One final piece of advice as you attempt to put value on what you do, whether you're a volunteer or part-time or full-time, it doesn't matter. Romans 12:13 says this, "For by grace given to me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each of you." The scripture encourages us not to think more highly of ourselves than we ought to, and I agree. What it does not encourage us to do is not think highly of ourselves at all. And so when we put value on our abilities, gifts, and talents, and are grateful and thankful for what God has done, and we put value on the ministry we do and the time we give to it, that is thinking highly of it. And I'm going to encourage you to continue to think that way because your work matters. All right, so leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think about the video. Do you feel like you are getting the respect you deserve for the work that you're doing? And tell me, why are you getting that respect? Is there any of the reasons that I mentioned, or maybe you have a few of your own? I would love to hear from you. If you're brand spanking new here, thank you for joining me here. I appreciate you watching. Be sure to click on my head over here somewhere, and that way you'll get videos like this in your inbox on a regular basis. Also, if you are a regular, thank you so much for being a part. I hope these videos are a blessing to you because I want you to know that your work matters, that you're an artist, and you're doing a good job. If nobody's told you that lately, I'm telling you, you're doing a good job.
Good job. Really good job.
So that's it for today, guys. Appreciate you guys hanging out, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Talk to you later.